I've got some great news about accessibility and journal papers. So this is actually about the journal called Ergonomics, which is a high-ranking UK journal about ergonomics and design. Now, you're probably familiar with normal journal papers in how you got a picture or a figure, and then below that, you've got a caption, and it's generally just describing what it's about. So this example from some work I did about 6 years ago, it's figure four, example of a mashup presenting VGI alongside PGI. Now, if you read the paper, you'll know what a mashup is, VGI is, and PGI is. But the rest of it, you just look at the picture and you work it out as you're going along. And we always assume that the reader can understand the picture, can see it clearly. This is not always the case because you can have various visual impairments. Somebody could be colorblind, they could be partially blind or full blind. So it's not really fair to put these important illustrations in journals if the person can't fully appreciate them, which is the announcement Ergonomics is making. Every figure in ergonomics from now on has to have alternative text. Now, this is an example of paper I'm writing right now. So before, it would be a simple flow diagram and the reader would view it and go, oh, that's how it works, that's great. And the caption would be just saying, oh, study tree. But now you're saying, we're going to describe it so that if somebody cannot see the images, the screen reader can actually describe what the image is as, and it's the author of the paper telling the reader what it is. So it's a really great advancement for accessibility, and it brings academic journals a step closer towards universal acceptance and in line with issues like WCAG 2.1, which does require alternative text for images on websites. So in this case, the figure text says, a flow diagram should have the study trees, humans, and body forms. Humans are allocated at random to be consecutively or non-consecutively scanned. Body forms are just scanned consecutively. So obviously there's a typo in there, I've got to correct that. But you really see how if you cannot fully see the image, if you can't view it, if you're partially sighted, my description will help bring this to life as a wonderful step forward. WCAG 2.1 is such an important part of accessibility, and it's great to see other forms of medium embracing it in the future as we go forward to more inclusive online web.